Good afternoon. First of all, before I even get started, let me just say, not only is this such an amazing day, but it is a beautiful day today, and so I am so grateful for this beautiful weather that we have. Welcome to Green Run Collegiate's commencement ceremony honoring the class of 2021. My name is Tanya Waters. I'm the International Baccalaureate Coordinator for Green Run Collegiate. And it is my honor to welcome you to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2021 at Green Run Collegiate. At this time, I would like to recognize our special guests. We ask that all guests stand and remain standing until everyone has been acknowledged. Please hold your applause until we have finished with everybody. At this time, I would like to recognize Green Run Collegiate governing board members, Dr. Peter Baker, Ms. Rebecca Bragg, Mr. Ron Taylor. I would also like to recognize Green Run Collegiate's foundation board, Mr. Joe Burnsworth, who serves as president, Dr. Sheila Magula, who serves as secretary, Delegate Glenn Davis. I would also like to recognize our school board members present today. Mrs. Beverly Anderson, Mrs. Sharon Felton, and Ms. Jennifer Franklin, Ms. Jessica Owens. And lastly, please welcome the Virginia Beach City Public Schools Administration, Dr. Aaron C. Spence, Superintendent, Dr. Donald E. Robertson, Chief School Officer, Mrs. Cheryl Woodhouse, Senior Executive Director of High School. We would also like to welcome our commencement speaker, Emmy Award-winning journalist, Ms. Katie Couric. I'm sorry, Ms. Katie Collette. Please join me in a warm GRC welcome.
Deb Anderson, Tessa Shiflett.
I would also like to welcome Beth Anderson and Trissa Shefflett. Finally, our celebration would not be complete without wishing you, our parents, and welcoming you, parents, family members, and friends, who are with us this afternoon to commemorate this momentous occasion. At this time, it is my honor to present to you this year's salutatorian, R.G. Cunanan.
Good afternoon. Before I leave you with the wisdom I picked up over these past 4 years, I'd like to thank everyone in this amphitheater. Thank you to our administrators, members of the governing board, foundation board, and the Virginia Beach School Board for providing us with new opportunities to make the most out of our high school years. Thank you to the teachers for spending time tutoring us and for being a shoulder to lean on. Parents, thank you for taking us to school when we would oversleep just for us to sleep in class. And thank you to the graduating class of 2021 for your perseverance in walking the path less traveled. This graduation could not have been possible without the time, effort, and persistence that everyone put into creating this reality. I'd like to give a special thanks to Denasia Smallwood, who was the one who encouraged me to apply to Green Run Collegiate. Thank you to my family for being very supportive of my endeavors. And most importantly, I'd like to give my utmost appreciation to my mom and my aunt for being the backbone of my motivation. Making it through high school, let alone an IB school, takes a lot of energy, motivation, and ambition. There'd be countless times when I get scolded for working too hard, but ironically, I would use those instances as a reason to work even harder. I do have to admit that, although I'm proud of my academic accomplishments, I find the most value in being able to deliver this speech. It allows me to shift the spotlight to all of you because you all deserve as much recognition as I do. As I witnessed firsthand the ups and downs of navigating through high school with some of the most distinctive individuals I've ever met, I realized that we all deserve to be first in the class rank. There are so many things that we have had to deal with and overcome, aside from schoolwork, that aren't reflected through our GPA. From trying to build and maintain friendships and relationships, balancing sports and our personal interests with schoolwork, being a parental figure to our siblings, working a job to help pay the bills, and simply maturing early by dealing with the preliminary effects of adulthood. There are other factors that we don't receive or give ourselves enough credit for. The fact that we were all resilient enough to make it out of the storm in the midst of a pandemic with other circumstances that were out of our control is a feat in itself. As you move on to the next chapter in your lives, please understand that there is no such ruler that can be used to measure our successes but our own. There always seems to be someone one step ahead of us, and there always will be, but their successes should only be taken as motivation and not self-degradation. It's unfair to use someone else's ruler when we all come from different systems of measure. As I failed numerous times to achieve my extreme academic standards and had phone calls with Aiden Hamilton at 2 a.m. in the morning, reminding me that there's more to life than just school, I realized that the important thing is to acknowledge the fact that I've given it my all, and that's the only ruler I need to measure my success. Now, this may be the last time that we will all be together, 6 feet apart, but it was truly a pleasure meeting the future generation of engineers, artists, biologists, military recruits, athletes, and everything in between. I was always inspired by your passions, whether it be school-related or not, because I recognized that we were all on the same road, just with different destinations. With that said, I encourage you all to make a change in the world. We won't be here for long, but we can all create an impact that will last forever. Whether it be tackling a global issue such as climate change or poverty, standing up for social issues such as racial discrimination to help stop Asian hate crimes and because Black Lives Matter, or even something as simple as educating ourselves and others so we can be more aware and understanding of our imperfect society, we're all capable of something, of contributing to something bigger than ourselves. And being the 2021 graduating class of GRC, I'm excited to see the impact that we can bring upon our society. Remember, never doubt your abilities, because all of you are equally as worthy and capable of the things you desire. I now leave you with two important quotes. From the words of 17th century poet William Ernest Henley, "You are the master of your fate and the captain of your soul." And more recently, from the words of songwriter Post Malone, "Congratulations, thank you."
Thank you, RG. It is now with my pleasure that I introduce to you this year's valedictorian for the class of 2021 at Green Run Collegiate, Aiden Hamilton.
Good afternoon, class of 2021, faculty, supportive family members, distinguished guests, and the best group of teachers I have ever known. It is my honor to be speaking to you today as valedictorian for Green Run Collegiate. Being in a school which calls upon the academic rigor like an IB program, I take comfort in what Ms. Eichner said at the beginning of our junior year. It is hard to be average. I found this idea interesting. What's so hard about being average? Well, being in IB is certainly not average. That's a given. But just being in IB was not enough for me. That is not what I wanted to search for. I will be forever grateful that my classmates and I were a small school of fish together in a big pond, as opposed to big fish with nowhere to grow. I'm so glad that I challenged myself on this journey, even at times when I felt discouraged or sad, those moments, especially in the past year, however long and arduous they felt, I learned were temporary. And well, I have to be thankful for those moments because look at us now. Here we are. I'm grateful for this moment. One of the many things I've loved about Green Run Collegiate and learning in general is I've really come to appreciate just how much I don't know. It is humbling, and it makes me realize just how precious knowledge is. There have been over 100 billion humans that have lived, and almost 8 billion of them are alive now. Each one of us are contributing members to that mass amount of knowledge and experiences within these 8 billion people. When I think about it this way, I can sometimes feel small and average. However, because of this, I've actually had an important revelation about what it actually means to be average. It means that you are not at the top and that there is work to do. There are more challenges to face, more setbacks to be had, more triumphs to celebrate. There is fun ahead and more discoveries in our long and winding roads. There is more to living than just a pond. There is an ocean to conquer. But sometimes I look into the future and it can feel so abstract because I think, how does this turn into that? I'm still trying to figure that one out. But there is a quote from Bill Gates which says, many people overestimate what they can do in a year and underestimate what they can do in a decade. This gives some answer to my question. Because now I see that shy little boy from first grade, and just over a decade later, I see this person standing in his place, and that is me. Not as a result of 1 year, but as an accumulation of all of them. Or, in Dr. Monte's terms, an integral. That's a calculus joke. So, seeing what we have accomplished so far, I'm confident for the future. I'm proud of what I have accomplished and extremely grateful to everyone who has helped me along the way. So, remember to trust your TOK way of knowing, intuition, because you don't need a weatherman to know which way the wind blows. And remember to keep on trucking. Thank you.
Thank you, RG and Aiden. At the Senior Awards Assembly on Friday, the Laureate Medallion winners were announced. The Laureate Medallion is presented to three seniors who have been nominated by their teachers and who have consistently exemplified one or more of the IB learner traits throughout their 4 years at GRC. The medallion recognizes students who have demonstrated excellence in service, compassion, inquiry, leadership, etc., thereby bringing honor and distinction to GRC. I would like to highlight a few points from each recipient's nomination. Recipients, when I call your name, please stand and remain standing. Kalia Karunka. Known for her work ethic and positive attitude, Kalia is the epitome of excellence. Throughout her 4 years at GRC, Kalia has shown dedication and commitment. She is a balanced, caring, principled young lady who has demonstrated outstanding academic achievements. She consistently reflects excellent service, compassion, inquiry, leadership, and all that we value at GRC and VBCPS. Both open-minded and focused, she is involved in a variety of activities outside of school, including NJROTC, Girl Scouts, Cross Country, Track, and Model United Nations. Kalia is a caring team player who helps her classmates whenever she sees the need. Kalia's volunteer work is always greatly appreciated, and her peers respect and compliment her on how quickly she is willing to help them and how knowledgeable she is. Kalia is a well-rounded student who embodies a lot of the IB learner traits by acting with honesty and integrity, a sense of duty, intense initiative, confidence in herself and her values, and an inquiring, intelligent mind. Deani Johnson. Deani is a true ray of sunshine who has consistently demonstrated positivity, focus, and grace. During her 4 years on Green Run's campus, she has participated in cheer, chorus, a variety of community service events, has maintained a strong academic record, all of this while working. Deani has been part of the Green Run cheer team for 4 years, where she has exhibited great leadership skills each year and has acted as a mentor to new cheerleaders when they joined the team. Deani has also been an excellent scholar, taking the initiative to approach her teachers with any questions she has. She takes responsibility for her success and commits to any task that she is given. The challenges of the last 2 years have been great, but Deani has never lost the determination to pursue success while supporting the growth of her fellow students. She truly exemplifies the best of Green Run Collegiate and is a cherished member of the community. There is no doubt that Deani will continue to bring joy, positivity, and love to everyone whose life she touches. Argy Cunanan. Argy was exceptionally courageous in his efforts to build belonging and connectivity in the virtual classroom. He was a true risk taker, taking chances to engage with his classmates and teachers to build bridges and connect us, which is a daunting challenge in a Zoom classroom. We all know that it's pretty easy to check in, but never really show up in a virtual lesson. But with his tireless energy and sheer will, he consistently attempted to connect with his peers and create a sense of belonging. He did this by trying to include everyone and wasn't afraid to jump into discussions or ask questions that would elicit responses from his peers. He would willingly team with different people instead of defaulting to the same friend group. These are exceptionally brave actions to maintain on a consistent basis when it would have been far easier to stay silent behind a black box. It was important that this student know that the seemingly little things he did every day were by no means little in consequence. They were noticed and appreciated by many of us. Lastly, we would like to bestow one last Laureate Medallion to Dr. Sheila Magula. Dr. Magula was integral in the creation of Green Run Collegiate, and upon retirement from Virginia Beach City Public Schools, continued advocating for the school as a member of both the governing board and the Green Run Collegiate Foundation. Dr. Magula, please accept this medallion, which Mr. Burnsworth has given you, for your years of service. Congratulations to all of our laureate recipients. At this time, I am so pleased to introduce our commencement speaker, Ms. Katie Collette. Ms. Collette is an Emmy Award-winning journalist and the morning and midday anchor at Wavy TV 10. She joined the station in 2007 as a reporter and worked her way up to her current anchor position. Ms. Collette is married and has a 7-year-old son. Her family adores their corgi, Ollie, and they are happy to call Virginia Beach home. Please give Ms. Collette a warm GRC Way welcome.
I don't know, I kind of didn't mind Katie Couric, because that would be $30 million more dollars. So I'm down with that. I'm good. So something that you need to know about me right off the bat is I always feel really nervous to speak at graduations. And I know I speak to hundreds of thousands of people a day, but graduations make my knees knock. And the reason for that is because I know you are not here for me. You want to see your children walk across that stage, and you graduates want to get your diplomas. Here's my promise to you. I'm going to be brief. You are welcome. Yeah, you can clap for that. I know. I get it. Yep. Do a little praise. We are good. Here's the deal, though. I do need just a touch of crowd participation in the beginning here. For example, please raise your hand if you feel you have ever been treated unfairly or you feel as though maybe you've been unfairly judged because of your age. Be on. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yes. Okay. How many of you feel like you haven't been picked for maybe a team, or maybe were passed over for a promotion because you're male or female? Mm-hmm. I love the honesty. Bring it. How many of you feel you've been discriminated against because of your appearance or maybe the color of your skin? Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So as you can see when you look around, you are not alone, and I am right there with you. When I was 21 years old, I had my first job interview to be a reporter at a TV station in Johnstown, Pennsylvania. I was excited because I sent out 85 resume tapes, and that shows you how old I am, because we couldn't just put a flash drive in and send it. They were tapes, 85 resume tapes. I was told no 84 times, if I even heard anything back at all. So the fact that I had this job interview was huge. I got to the TV station in my brand new olive green suit and pale pink top underneath. I didn't have a lot of money, and what I had, I spent on that suit. During my interview, the news director named Gary had me write stories all day that aired in the newscasts. It was an 8-hour interview. He didn't offer me a break to eat. He didn't offer me anything to drink. And at the end of the day, he told me that if he offered me the job, I would need to cut my hair because it would make me look older. I would need to lose weight. I would need to bleach my teeth. And I shouldn't wear olive green suits or pale colors because I'm white and those colors wash me out. I was devastated. I cried all the way home. And then the next day, I got a call from Gary. He offered me the job. I was stunned. Getting a job in this business is very, very hard, but I would never, ever, ever want to work for a person like that. So you know what I did? I took the job. I took that job because I wanted to be a reporter, and I wanted to show Gary that I could be a great reporter. So I did cut my hair. I did bleach my teeth. I still ate French fries. We're not going to talk about the weight loss. And he was eventually fired for being unethical and just a terrible person. It's a thing called karma. So I climbed my way to the morning anchor position at that TV station in Pennsylvania when I applied for my job at Wavy. Now, the interview at Wavy was amazing. It was unlike anything I had ever experienced. I felt appreciated, welcomed, respected. I got the job as a reporter at Wavy in 2007. I eventually became the weekend morning anchor, but after a while on that shift, I felt like I wasn't climbing anymore. I felt stuck in that position and I wanted to grow, so I applied for several positions at other TV stations across the country. I was a finalist for several. One I didn't get because a friend of mine at the station told me they needed a man, not a woman. Another I wasn't even considered for because I'm white and they needed a person of color. That was according to one of their managers, who I knew very well through the television industry. Are any of those things legal? Not really. But representation matters, and the news is included in that. Think about it. You don't want to watch a newscast and no one there represents you. And we as journalists know that. So I decided to try and get an agent. They have the in when it comes to what television stations are looking for. They know if a station wants a man, wants a woman, wants someone of a certain race or ethnicity. So they can say, don't apply there, we're gonna apply here instead. Thing about agents is, you have to apply. And if they like your work and what they see, then they will accept you. I had multiple agents say they weren't taking on new clients. Others said they liked my work, but I wasn't what they were looking for. Finally, a woman who is an agent at a pretty big company gave me a call. She told me my work was great, but she wanted to give me some friendly advice. And we all know how friendly advice goes. She said to me, I know this may be hard for you to hear, but you are too girl next door. I highly recommend you consider changing your last name to something like Gonzalez so you can get your foot in the door. So I almost dropped my phone. I thanked her for her advice, and I decided an agent wasn't for me after all. I decided it was important to be true to who I am. I am the girl next door. I believe in the power of smiling and happiness and kindness, being friendly. I have auburn hair and freckles. My real name is Katie Collette. So now years later, I stand here before you as Katie Collette, co-anchor of the number one newscast in Hampton Roads, Wavy News 10 Today. And I did that without an agent. And let me tell you, nothing feels better than reaching your goals by being utterly and truly you. Don't get me wrong, life will change you. In a year, 2 years, maybe more, you'll be different than the person sitting here today. Little things that bothered you in high school, trust me, they're just not going to matter anymore. And that is a good thing. That is called growth. As you head out into the big world of college and careers, remember that it is okay to bend a little when someone makes a suggestion, even if you don't completely agree with them. Sometimes you have to play the game to get to where you want to be, just like when I took that first job at that first television station. But no matter how life changes you, never forget who you truly are inside, or even the person you would like to become. Right now, I'm looking out at some of the strongest group of teenagers I have ever seen in my life. You survived a pandemic. You survived high school in a pandemic. That is amazing. I can't say I did that. Your parents can't say they did that. You are off to the most unique start on this amazing adventure we call life. And your ability to overcome the obstacles you faced over the last year and a half, 2 years, shows us all you are more than ready to walk across this stage and take on the world. So cheers to you, class of 2021. There will never be another group of people like you. Embrace your uniqueness. Thank you.
Ms. Collette, please accept a small gift as a token of our gratitude for your insights today. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Tamisha, I already see you. Class of 2021, thank you. You have always been present in our hearts and in our minds since that fateful March 13th day. Although we were Zoom rooms apart, we thought about you constantly. Our minds were filled on how we could support you through the IB curricula, college applications, graduation requirements, and mental health. For every failed plan, we picked ourselves up and pushed ourselves to think differently. What angle were we missing that would allow us to find a solution for you? And for every plan that succeeded, we celebrated quickly and kept moving. For we could not rest, because for every problem solved, another problem was lurking around the corner. We were constantly on the move. We called, we visited homes, we gave rides to school, we coached you, we argued with you, we encouraged you, and we frustrated you. But we never, ever gave up on you. And so now, just for this moment, just for this moment, we can all stand still to bask in this celebration. We have much to be grateful. Despite of this pandemic, all of you, all of your class will graduate, 100% on-time graduation. 93% of you will have graduated with an advanced diploma, and 58% of you will have earned the status of graduating with honors. Rejoice in your achievements because they were hard-fought and well-deserved. All of us, from your teachers to your parents to you, you worked together to bring us to this milestone event. So how precious is our humanity, our connection to others? Although for most of the year we were never in constant proximity to one another, it is our humanity that binds us and what ultimately led us here today. So what does it mean to connect, to forge meaningful, worthwhile relationships? It includes honest conversations, tough discussions that allow us to face certain realities about ourselves. It gives us opportunities to reflect, to think about our choices and the impacts they make. It catapults us to act in the hopes that we become better people as a result of being in each other's presence. It gives us the power to forgive, for it is in the grace of this act that we can begin again, renewed and yet wiser, more capable to empower, to serve, and to lead. As you leave Green Run Collegiate and your family, I pray that you do not forget that it was the relationships conceived here that led to your growth and your success. Seek others, both similar and different, from you. Reach out to those who need your support. Find help when you need it. Ask for feedback. Don't hold back from those who want what is best for you and whose only desire is to see you at your very best. Quick trivia, John Donne is my favorite British poet. My parting words are his words. Our feelings are one and the same. No man is an island entire of itself. Every man is a piece of the continent, a part of the main. If a clod be washed away by sea, Europe is the less, as well as if a promontory were, as well as any manner of thy friends or of thine own were. Any man's death diminishes me because I am involved in mankind. And therefore, never send to know for whom the bell tolls. It tolls for thee. Find people who will be honest with you, who will inspire you to reflect, who will ignite you to act with conviction, who will embolden you to forgive. We are at our very best when we put our humanity at the forefront. Thank you for listening one last time. Hopefully we'll get this better than our entrance. Faculty and staff, please prepare for the distribution of the diplomas.
Parents, families, and guests, we ask that you please refrain from excessive celebration until after all the graduates' names have been called. Please remember that we want every family to hear their graduate's name be called as soon as he or she receives their diploma. Ruth Abesalom. Andrew John Adams. Dominique Christina Adams. Hannah Ama Pakua Ajiman. Brendan Miles Baker. Savannah Lee Balling. Jasmine P. Blagg. Ryan C. Brereton. Jarrell J. Broadbent. Liera Brooks. Anaya Sheree Burnham. Alize Cabada Alvarado. Ciela Maria Castillo. Abigail Cortopasso. Argy Bia Cunanan. Kai E. Daniels. Fifalana Okunulau Wakibe Fadairo. Amber Veronica Gamboa. Adric Lamont Gill. Talon Clifton Glover. Janaya Amia Goodhope Colbert. William Robert Goodwin. Aiden James Hamilton. Reed M. Hammond. Marquita LaDon Harding. Naya Lane Harris. James A. Hart, Jr. Yeah. Jocelyn S.M. Hare. Trinity Chanel Hicks. Kaylin Marie Isidro. Kylie Jenkins. Deani A. Johnson. Raven Kaija Johnson. Javian Marquez Jones. Xavier Armand Kinnear. Kalia Elizabeth Warnack Karunka. Josephine Anna Laverty. Angelina Maria Lane. Abigail H. Lee. Hannah R. Loomis. Crystalline Ann Manikas. Mackenzie Claire Martone. Virginia Grace McKinnon. Madison D. McPhee. Summer A. Murak. Andrew Damon Owens. Ashley Mae Pekansky. Tamisha Levette Parker. Javen Porter. Ayana Niche Pugh. John Paulo Reed. Juwan DeAndre Dorian Robertson. Rosie Rodriguez. Noreen Joy Sevilla. Danasia Janae Smallwood. Yeah. Bailey R. Snead. Ebony Stewart. Nyla Renee Talley. Aaron Tang. Cecilia Chanel Tate. Ian M. Terry. Mia Cosette Thompson. Zachary Alexander Vaughn. Samuel Hawangwa Webb. Mary Alexis Wisher. Joshua Tyler Wolf. Bradley Joseph Ziemba. At the conclusion of the ceremony, we ask that all graduates remain in their seats for the graduate reception. Guests and graduates will exit from different sides of the amphitheater. Graduates, please wait.
At this time, I'd like to ask all faculty members to take their places. Class of 2021, may you please stand? It is my privilege to certify that these candidates have fulfilled the requirements set forth by the Commonwealth of Virginia and the School Board of the City of Virginia Beach. It is with great, great pride that I present to you, parents, audience, leaders of Virginia Beach City Public Schools, the graduating class of 2021. Graduates, please switch your tassels. I now declare that you have graduated. Never cease to fail me. Thank you.
okay, you may start departing now.